Thank you. we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Since then, we have such a hope. We act with great boldness, not like Moses, who put a veil over his face to keep the people of Israel from gazing at the end of the glory that was being set aside. But their minds were hardened. Indeed, to this very day, when they hear the reading of the Old Covenant, that same veil is still there, since only in Christ is it set aside. Indeed, to this very day, whenever Moses is read, a veil lies over their minds. But when one turns to the Lord, the veil is removed. Now the Lord is the Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. And all of us, with unveiled faces, seeing the glory of the Lord as though reflected in a mirror, are being transformed into the same image from one degree of glory to another. For this comes from the Lord, the Spirit. Therefore, since it is by God's mercy that we are engaged in this ministry, we do not lose heart. We have renounced the shameful things that one hides. We refuse to practice cunning or to falsify God's word. But by the open statement of the truth, we commend ourselves to the conscience of everyone in the sight of God. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
While he was coming, the demon dashed him to the ground in convulsions.
But Jesus rebuked the unclean spirit, healed the boy, and gave him back to his father. And all were astounded at the greatness of God. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Not knowing what he said. comes while he's talking. And from that cloud is a voice. This is my son, my chosen. Listen to him. That might be one of the hardest challenges we have in our journey of faith. Listen to him. This is my son, my chosen. I have given him to you. Now listen. This Wednesday we'll begin our Lenten journey. And I invite us to make this our journey. Whether you want to give things up or take things on, let us listen to God. God incarnate in each other, in community, at the table of Eucharist, in our wilderness times. Listen to him. Now Jesus knows, they don't even acknowledge Peter, Simon Peter in this. But there's an option to leave off our second part of our gospel today. And it's a really crucial, important part. Jesus is there with Moses and Elijah preparing for his departure, his exodus, turning his face towards Jerusalem and the cross. And they come down to them from the mountain. They don't stay up there. They come down into the fray. A great crowd met him. Just then, a man from the crowd shouted, "Teacher, I beg you to look at my son, my only child." We in our world and in our current culture are in the fray, in the midst of pain. In the midst of pain on top of pain. Newborns in basement, isolettes that aren't even isolettes, makeshift hospitals. An 80-year-old man showed up at the war front in Ukraine with his bag packed with two t-shirts, a pair of pants, and he said, "I do this for my grandchildren." And in the midst of us is the pain and resurrection. And in this listening, we are invited to pray. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Eternal God, in whose perfect kingdom no sword is drawn, but the sword of righteousness, no strength known, but the strength of love. So mightily spread abroad your spirit, that all peoples may be gathered under the banner of the Prince of Peace, as children of one Creator, to whom be dominion and glory now and forever. Amen. As we set our eyes towards Jerusalem, may we encourage and hold one another in a space to listen to God in our midst. Amen.
In peace, we pray to you, O God. For all people in their daily life and work.
For our families, friends, and neighbors, and for those who are alone.
For this community, the nation, and the world.
For all who work for justice, freedom, and peace.
For the just and proper use of your creation.
For the victims of hunger, fear, injustice, and oppression.
For all who are in danger, sorrow, or any kind of trouble.
For those who minister to the sick, the friendless, and the needy.
For the peace and unity of the Church of God.
For all who proclaim the gospel and all who seek the truth.
For all bishops, priests, and other ministers.
For all who serve God and the Church.
For the special needs and concerns of this congregation, we especially pray for Susan Abold, Kathy Adams, Leslie Menino, Cindy Bodemos, Brian Douglas, Ann George, Dylan Gura, Alan Goldberg, and David Kosnick, Michael Kimball, James Martin, the Roche family, Mary Jo Schwan, Lisa Striving, the people of Afghanistan, the people of Tonga, the people of Ukraine, and the people of Russia. And finally, we pray for the repose of the soul of Arlene Borgeson. Hear us, Lord.
For your mercy is great.
We thank you, God, for all the blessings of this life. We will exalt you, O God, our King,
and praise your name forever and ever.
We pray for all who have died, that they may have a place in your eternal kingdom. God, let your loving kindness be upon them who put their trust in you.
O Lord our God, accept the fervent prayers of your people and the multitude of your mercies. Look with compassion upon us and all who turn to you for help, for you are gracious, O lover of souls. To you we give glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
You can go, girls, and pop up.
Thank you.
Watch and Pray with Holly Murray, the movie for that. That is also in your e-blast. If you don't get the e-blast, let us know and we'll make sure to include you. Also, Ash Wednesday begins this Wednesday, as I mentioned. So March 2nd, we have services at 12:30 and 7 o'clock p.m. You're welcome to join us for that. Next Sunday, we also have services at 8 and 10, adult education at 11:15, 12:30, and then we have our choir concert at 4 o'clock p.m. with a reception to follow. I encourage you all to join into that lively time. And then you can end your day with a 6 p.m. simple evening worship and food and fellowship. So we encourage you to partake in any of those that you feel called to. Also, there's more about those Sunday evenings in Lent, and then Church Next is offering a free resource on systemic racism in the Episcopal Church, and more information about that. And then also, the invitation to group spiritual direction is in here, and I encourage you to look through that and see if that sounds like it might be something for your Lenten journey. Also, one other thing, next Sunday, as you have noticed, we are making the decision tomorrow about masking. I know many of you will feel more comfortable masking, and we respect everybody to gather safely, so more information about that coming out this week. But we thank you for caring for one another in all ways we can. Let us with gladness present the offerings and oblations of our life and labor to God.
Thank you.
source of life abundant. From before time you made ready to creation. Your spirit moved over the deep and brought all things into being. Sun, moon, and stars, earth, winds, and waters, and every living thing. You made us in your image and taught us to walk in your ways, but we rebelled against you and wandered far away. And yet, as a mother cares for her children, you would not forget us. Time and again you called us to live in the fullness of your love. And so this day we join with saints and angels in the chorus of praise that rings through eternity, lifting our voices to magnify you as we sing. peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you now and always.